नमस्ते, गुड इवनिंग ऑल. मायसेल्फ उदय वाकावाला, सीईओ एआईसी रामभाव मालगी प्रबोधिनी फाउंडेशन विच इज सपोर्टेड बाय अटल इनोवेशन मिशन, नीति आयोग, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. वेलकम ऑल टू द फोर्थ एपिसोड ऑफ बातचीत, वेर इन वी गेट सीजन मेंटर्स, एक्सपर्ट्स एंड बडिंग एंटरप्रेन्योर्स, इनोवेटर्स फ्रॉम द स्टार्टअप इकोसिस्टम टू स्पीक, शोकेस देयर वर्क एंड सीज द अपॉर्चुनिटी. In this virtual world now, our attempt is to have simple conversations, what we call it as baatcheet, so that our FB viewers can learn from the experiences of our guests. We selected women entrepreneurs this time. The reason, let me tell you, it's not 8th of March, not International Women's Day, but yeah, this is something that we sincerely believe in, that women has got the power. Rather, our team, we have a member, and then our mentors, a lot of them are women, and then entrepreneurs as well, the startups, the incubators that we support. We would love to have more and more women entrepreneurs getting supported. Let me add here that Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog, they also have a lot of women-centric programs and initiatives. And this is what we would love to support within the ecosystem, that more and more women entrepreneurs should come forward, because the kind of talent, the kind of entrepreneurial mindset that they have, and the kind of their man management skills, I believe that's the key word out here. They can manage a lot of stuff, and that is what entrepreneurs is really made up of. So it's a pleasure to have resourceful and hustling two women entrepreneurs in our baatcheet today. First, I would call that person as a sheer networker, who's an expert, well-wisher of AIC RMP, and also Rambhav Malgi Prabodhini, which is our host institution. And we have a promising startup, rather, I wouldn't call it as a promising now. It's an upcoming startup in a way that has won award as well from our cohort one. So let me first introduce our expert first. That's Renu Soman, who's the founder of Womankind.
Hello.
She's a brand and communication expert, and she's been working in this space relentlessly for quite some time. That's about her Womankind initiative, which has been sort of looking at the community of women getting into very exciting, interesting sort of journey for those women, in a way that they understand the branding communication part as well, and come up with new ventures within different space. That could be even fashion, that could be even F&B, whatever that could be. But then her role has been very instrumental in this entire ecosystem. I would like Renuji to lead this conversation, and also introduce our guest, that is Shefalika Sharma from Fruits, to take this baatcheet forward. Thank you all the viewers who have joined in today, and watch out for this space for more such exciting conversations. Over to you, Renuji. So in this woman talks, I don't want to be the kind of a factor wherein I poke in my nose and then talk something which I believe that I very well understand, but then surely, I mean, woman has got all the power. So over to both
of you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Uday. Hello and good evening, everybody. A big thanks to AIC RMP, Atal Incubation Center, Rambhav Malgi Prabodhini, the entire family, the way I see it, it is for always being positive and encouraging. And I today will be talking, we will be doing this baatcheet with Shefalika, again, and Shefalika is about Womankind. A brief introduction of Shefalika. Shefalika is founder of Fruits Technology Private Limited. She also jointly conducted by Ministry of Agriculture, Krishi. Educationally, she is an agriculture graduate from the G. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology. Well, besides that, she also an MBA from Symbiosis Institute, Pune. Professionally, she has worked across companies like GE and Bharti AXA at senior positions. So she also has a good bit of corporate experience under her belt. She has renounced her corporate life. I like the word renounced. To do something meaningful, which is as impact, as is also doing this. Found she engages and empowers urban individuals to grow either their own food or to get access to fresh, safe, and nutrient-rich vegetables from local traceable farms. Now, this may sound very tough, but it actually is not. And it's not actually tough for women who are always, you know, fretting about which is the best place to buy the freshest vegetables, which is more, you know, reliable. So I don't think women are going to find this puzzling at all. So Shefalika, are we good to go? Should I start with some questions?
Yes, please.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Renuji. I would like to thank you for the introduction. And thank you, AICRMP, for giving this platform to talk and express what we feel and what challenges we face. Thank you so much.
Let's begin with the rapid fire. It's a very, very simple, very, very logical question, which is, so you've been, like, you've done a great in terms of education. You have some very fantastic degrees. But then why did you decide to venture into agriculture? At what point did you feel, you know, okay, let's do this?
I'm very passionate about agriculture. So this has always been on my mind. But moreover, what acted as a trigger was being a mother of two children, you know, fetching for safest, pesticide-free, chemical-free, rich in nutrition, veggies and greens. And, you know, something which I can fearlessly offer to them. So that's something which I always used to wonder, you know, where are these veggies coming from? What is being sold on the, you know, these kiosks and jo thele pe mil raha hai, how has it been grown? Where has it been grown? During the supply chain, wo kitni der se, how long has it been on the shelf? And is it okay if I use a bit of Hindi in between?
Oh yes, Hindi hamari rashtrabhasha hai, zarur baat karenge Hindi mein, please.
So this is something which constantly used to bother me. And then, you know, visually seeing some of the things like Panvel ke railway track pe palak ug raha hai, and then thele pe jo bik raha hai wo pani mein aise hum log bar bar gande paint ki bucket ke andar pani bhar ke ganda usme bar bar dubo dubo ke rakh rahe hain. So all that used to bother me. So and I have been an agriculture graduate, as you told. So I always had this thought also in mind that this green revolution at that time, it was very important for us. Mm-hmm. So that's why we started using, you know, chemical fertilizers, chemical pesticides. But while doing so, somehow we missed, you know, we started doing more harm rather than, you know, improving the productivity of the farmers. Because from the consumer perspective, what output of produce we started getting was, you know, causing was full of a lot of carcinogenic pesticides, chemical fertilizers, which can really cause type 1 diabetes. And there's a statistics that around 40% of our diseases in the current scenario are because of our diet or what we are eating. So that's why I really wanted to do something around it.
Right.
That's
right.
When I decided that at least I should grow my own vegetables for myself.
Yeah, for your children, for your family. I think that's the biggest pleasure and, you know, satisfaction a woman can have, that my children are eating good food. My family, I'm serving them fresh vegetables. Mm-hmm. And I think most Indian houses, there may be different viewpoints, but yes, vegetables is a staple. So yeah. There are non-veg eating families as well. I mean, they also eat non-veg, but I don't think you have families who will not eat vegetables at all. Mm-hmm. So if we are a growing population of 1.34 billion and galloping, I think vegetables has this market, you know, if we can, you know, even mm-hmm. begin to fathom that.
That's what I thought, at least main apne liye apni life pe change kar leti hu, at least let me start growing my own, kyunki maine itna 4 saal agriculture padha, wahan pe growing sikha, and then I did not actually practice it. So I thought this is the time to start practicing it in real life. And that's when humne Juhu mein ek chote se terrace pe shuru kiya. Ek friend terrace hai, so humne wahan pe usse baat karke ek 500 square feet ka terrace site set up kiya. एंड वेजिटेबल्स ग्रो करना शुरू किया. एंड यू वोंट बिलीव द काइंड ऑफ टेस्ट एंड द काइंड ऑफ क्वालिटी विच वॉज देयर इन दैट पालक, धनिया, सैलेड ग्रीन्स, बेसिल, जो भी हमने ग्रो किया वॉज इमेंस, इमेंसली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम वॉट वी गेट.
True, true. So yes, I also belong to Pune. I'm born, brought up, educated in Pune. And fresh vegetables was a given. Fresh, tasty, and you know, rasile jaise, matlab, you know, fruits or so. Aise, we never had to be forced ki fruit khao, fruit khao, ek to fruit khao. I don't think our parents ever bothered. They were so busy with their lives. Fruits jaise ghar mein aate the, we used to like toot pado. So now I understand the whole, you know, thought process and philosophy that you have behind starting this, or why would you begin this at all? My next question to you is, so tell me about your company, your venture, and what you offer, and you know, how you do things in Fruits Technologies Private Limited.
So, see, because it's something which I experienced myself and my family experienced ourselves. So, I thought, why not share it with the larger community? So, I thought, agar sab log ugane lage, har second, third ghar mein hum log ugane lage, to kitna amazing ho jayega. So, that's the thought which came in my mind, wherein I thought, let's start training people and let's start having self-learning modules around how people can grow their own food. And how they can maximize the nutrition which they are getting per square foot, because people are doing at the convenience of their homes.
Right.
So ek to hum logon ne wo karna shuru kiya. Dusra, I started working with a lot of farms in the vicinity of Pune and Mumbai. So I identified local farms jo already kar rahe hain. And for 3-4 seasons humne rigorously उन लोग के साथ को ग्रो किया. When I say co-growing, essentially we looked at how to, you know, we can maximize productivity for them. कौन से new age techniques हैं which we can adopt and which we can localize in our Indian context and we can use in those farms so that उनकी productivity बढ़े. तो जैसे simple चीज़ है, जैसे हम लोग we started going vertical. अभी hydroponics और aeroponics sounds really
exotic,
fascinating. बट उसको लोकल कॉन्टेक्स्ट में रेलेवेंट करना और उसके उससे इंस्पिरेशन लेके हाइब्रिड सिस्टम्स बनाना, दैट्स व्हाट वी स्टार्टेड डूइंग. बेसिकली द गुड थिंग्स अबाउट दीज कॉन्सेप्ट्स लाइक वाटर कंजर्वेशन एंड सो दैट दोज एलिमेंट्स वी इन्फ्यूज्ड इन आर सॉइल बेस्ड ग्रोइंग. और हम लोगों ने वर्टिकल सिस्टम्स एंड इस तरह के टेक्निक्स यूज करना शुरू किया टू मैक्सिमाइज प्रोडक्टिविटी, सो दैट द ग्रोअर इज ऑल्सो बेनिफिटेड और वो टेम्प्ट ना हो कि प्रोडक्टिविटी आर्टिफिशियली बूस्ट करने के लिए वो ग्रोथ सिम्युलेटर्स डाले या एक्स्ट्रा फर्टिलाइजर्स डाले और फिर सॉइल का अब्यूज हो और सॉइल में केमिकल्स लीच हो जाए. ओवर यूज ऑफ केमिकल्स विल, यू नो, थोड़े दिनों के बाद हमारा सॉइल यूजलेस हो जाएगा अगर हम इसी तरीके से एक्सप्लॉइट करेंगे सॉइल.
एक्सप्लॉइट करेंगे. सो टू समराइज और टू अंडरस्टैंड और एनकैप्सुलेट व्हाट यू जस्ट सेड, सो फ्रूट्स टेक्नोलॉजीज इज एन एग्रीकल्चर स्टार्टअप headed by Shefalika, of course. And Shefalika, is you also sell vegetables? Is that the first thing?
Yes.
You sell vegetables?
Finding, see, the loop is closed only when we get market for whatever we are growing.
Exactly.
So, ek bar grow ho gaya, achhe se, using credible inputs, using sustainable techniques, uske baad market linkages is very crucial. So
very crucial.
We are trying to reach out to like-minded, you know, consumers, jo ki appreciate karte hain that what goes inside growing this.
Right.
And why is it so important to buy?
So when you said what goes into, you know, creating this or producing this or growing this, I think I have to mention my dadi with whom I grew up. And she always gave this maxim called Anna Tashi Buddhi. So this is in Marathi, which means आप जिस तरह का खाना खाओगे, जिस तरह का अन्न ग्रहण करोगे, उसी तरह की बुद्धि आपको, you'll think in the similar way. So I think all this, even if we don't go to the entire बुद्धि aspect, I think what you eat and how it is grown will affect your health positively or negatively. Am I correct?
Very true, very true.
how does it help so what is fresh? So how fresh is fresh? One day, 24 hours, 48 hours, what do you call fresh?
So that's another part of our offering is when we say fresh, it's like same day harvest. प्री-ऑर्डर बेसिस पे हम लोग काम करते हैं, हम लोग कंज्यूमर से ऑर्डर लेते हैं, हम लोग स्टॉक नहीं करते हैं बिकॉज हमारा नेटवर्क ऑफ फार्म्स है, हमारे डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड फार्म्स हैं. ऑर्डर लेने के बाद सुबह 4 बजे 5 बजे मेरे बच्चे जाकर के वहाँ से तोड़ के लाते हैं एंड देन वी एंश्योर के सेम डे इट इज डिलीवर्ड सो दैट इट्स पैक्ड इन न्यूट्रिशन. इसका एक और एस्पेक्ट है रेनोजी, के अब जैसे पालक का मैं आपको एग्जाम्पल देती हूँ. पालक हम लोग आयरन के लिए तो खाते ही है, वो सब जानते हैं. But palak is very rich in vitamin A and vitamin C also.
Okay.
And the moment it is plucked from the plant, uska nutrient depletion shuru ho jata hai.
Achha.
And we start losing all those vitamin A or vitamin C lose hone lagta hai.
So, it's like a countdown.
Yeah. So that's why the sooner we eat it, the more nutrition we get out of it.
Right.
Aur agar wo 4 din 5 din shelf pe rakha rahega, then it's like there is no nutrition left in it. So that's why for us at fruits, fresh is like same day. Aaj toota, aaj khaya. Oh,
that's a tall order, Chef Alika. Hum to ghar mein bhi itna dhyan nahi rakhte hain, no? You like, so we tend to kind of stock 3 din ki sabji lai, ya, you know, you like 4 din ki lai, and you know, you feel, haan, ghar mein sabji hai. But I think we, as women, as mothers, as wives, as daughters, daughter-in-laws, all of us in all different roles need to look at this, you know, just pause and think that are we eating the right thing and are we sourcing it right? Because everything is so nicely packaged and, you know, nicely branded and expensive. So people who stay in metros, you know, they don't get it cheap. They get very, very expensive vegetables. At the same time, I don't think they get all the nutrients that are necessary. And so let's call your fresh as hyper fresh. Hyper fresh vegetables from Chef Alika. Good. So how has the journey been? What were the challenges that you faced? Was it smooth ride or tough?
It was very tough. एक तो जो 23 years back agriculture में सीखा था वो सब भूल गया था. So it's like putting it into practice and reviving it and was a task. But doing it for the past 2 years, I feel really happy. And सबसे पहले for startups, you know, I think जो talking in context of startup, एक सबके दिमाग में ना there is a mental block. People feel के startups by default failure होते हैं, 80% startups fail हो जाते हैं. So that's what is, you know, fed in our minds. So I feel
that the environment keeps telling us that, you know, the kind of news we get, the kind of inputs we get. I understand where you come from. Yes.
So you know the biggest challenge, personal challenge which I faced initially was ke job chhod ke sab itna acha chal raha hai and wo sara career path aur growth ko chhod ke and then get into something which is drastically different because my entire experience is in strategic planning, corporate finance, valuation modeling. Abhi wo sara 17 years ka experience chhod ke suddenly getting back to agriculture. So that was, I think, the toughest.
Yeah,
to convince myself that
the whole unlearning must have been like really
it was. And then the other thing which I think is startup is a long journey, so there are ups and there are highs. So someday you are like on top of the world and the other days you are like alone and so that's something that the sooner we accept that there is, no place for complacency, there is no place for criticism. You just have to, you know, keep striving up and keep going up. And so that's, I think, the biggest challenge which is there.
So you need to change your mindset is what you are telling us. So you can't be giving any concessions to yourself.
Exactly. So when you are doing a startup, you have to be tough. From within and be ready to again and again get up. Bar bar giro, bar bar utho.
That's inspiring. That's truly inspiring.
Yes. All 10,000 times and get up 10,000 times.
Right. So though I would not like to make it very, you know, connected to any gender, but yes, did you face any specific issues because you are a woman entrepreneur, or just because you are a woman entrepreneur? Let's put it that way.
I think yes, being a woman entrepreneur is thoda sa extra tough. Because specifically, if I relate it to myself, being a married woman, being a mother of two daughters, having, you know, expectations from family at home that you are, you know, and the stereotyping mindset that, okay, you are supposed to be at home, take care of kids, you know, so breaking that and, you know, telling people that please come out of this mindset that women are only able or capable of doing this, and this is their job to sit at home and take care of home. That is important. I agree. I don't deny that that is important, but striking a balance between both as a woman entrepreneur is a challenge. So that is something which I feel is very difficult, and it comes over.
It's a tough thing to do, tough thing. But yes, I completely agree with you, because when I speak to other women entrepreneurs from womankind.
Yeah, in fact, you've been mentoring more than 500 women entrepreneurs. So you tell me, how is the experience with others?
So I always tell them, maybe because I'm from a communication background, I keep saying this to them, please talk, please explain, please write. Please tell, and again and again and again, because I think modern life is a very challenging life itself. मतलब ज़िंदगी एक challenge है, जीना एक challenge हो गया है कि रोज़ office जाओ, you know, एक 1 hour journey to office. Now thanks to COVID, we don't have to do that, or most people don't have to do that. But otherwise, it's a very stressful life that we lead, and all the family members who love you, who support you, would only be able to do it better if you co-opt them. So that's the word I use when I talk to my women entrepreneur friends. And I think you must have done exactly the same, you know, because family support is so crucial, that they understand you, that they stand by you. Even if they don't actually come out and do the deliveries for you, but I think just they being with you and standing by you makes a huge, huge difference in our lives. Exactly. And our ability to do better.
That is true. That is true. So we can do only what we are expected to do once there are certain things which are taken care of and people are supportive. So thankfully, my family has been supportive. My husband, my kids all have been very supportive. So
Right. That's because you gave them fresh sabji, tasty, tasty khana.
That's because I left my dinse rataka nice job and started doing something. Right. I started balancing better.
That's true. Very true. So, what are the challenges as an entrepreneur? Just entrepreneur. What stops you from growing big and bigger?
See, basically as an entrepreneur, I think I would say two things. One is, you know, better access to capital, risk capital, so that you can, you know, take bets and you can just grow the way you want to grow. And the second, I think, is a better access to talent pool. So when you're building the team, that is very, very critical, because ultimately nobody alone, you can just grow this much, and it's only collectively that you are able to achieve what
the exponential that you are looking at.
Exactly. And third, when you talk about exponential, obviously scaling it, so you can, matlab shuru ke 1,000 orders lana is not difficult, but scaling it from 1,000 to 10,000, 10,000 to a lakh is what is tough. So
it's a critical part.
Yeah.
Right. So
also, I would like to add, you know, as an as a agriculturist and being a woman in agriculture, that's something which I don't know keeps bothering me, because when we go to farms, also, even you must have seen that there are women play such a critical role. And
all over India, yes. Yes,
they should be given respect and due of the credit, or the credit of what they are doing and how they are, you know, toiling and working hard to make, because me and you sitting here can, you know, we are, I think, privileged that we get credit of what we do. There are many women who don't get credit of what they do. So probably that's my urge to people to, you know, be supportive to that segment of women.
Right. So I completely agree with you. And it's so nice that you brought this up, because India is a predominantly agricultural economy. Even today, though we have the, you know, sunrise industries, different industries that, you know, keep, you know, riding the wave. At the same time, agriculture will be agriculture, and it's not going anywhere. And the more our population increases, the more we need to, you know, worry about food, food for all, food security. And I have seen it myself in different parts of Maharashtra and India, that it's the women who are, you know, toiling away in the farms. I'm not saying men don't do it. Of course, they also have a role to play. But it's not that the women are just nowhere. They work hard and they are in the farms. So be it any state of India. And I think they deserve a better place in the sun as far as agriculture goes. I don't know what, how we can help them, you know, have better rights or better respect. But yes, this thought is important. And hope it happens and, you know, hope the right authorities think about this, listen to this and take some action on this. So if we can say as a woman entrepreneur, agriculturist, what is your ask? And what is your ask for the future? Where do you see the future for yourself or agriculture?
Really current state of agriculture is, there are many problems in different areas. Like if I talk about production related, there are a separate set of problems which we have. Then the produce quality related, there are a separate set of issues which are there. Then if we talk about availability or access to food, there are different set of challenges there. And when we talk about environment, there is a very, very drastically, you know, different challenge there, which is, you know, urging us to really do something about it. So what I think is that there are many people who are working in different areas, in separate areas. So what I really feel is that there is a need for all of us to collaborate and, you know, really make a great ecosystem for growing, for making it available for the supply chain aspect of it, making it available to the consumers. So there is a need of, you know, leveraging partnerships, coming together and not working in silos and not trying to compete against each other.
Right.
And I think I would, I think I feel that comes naturally to women, you know, trying to empathize with others and trying to
be there for each other
and grow together. So so that is something which I think is very important going forward. And for agriculture specifically, if you ask me, through our fruits or through our this effort which we are trying to do in fruits technologies, which is food with good roots, so we are trying to act twofold. So from the consumer's perspective, we are trying to ensure that there is a zero contamination and safe and high nutrient quality ka produce available. And from the grower's perspective, there is a lot of scope which we are working on to maximize yield, you know, come together on a single platform for collectivization, leverage economies of scale. I'm talking specifically about the small scattered growers. So there are multiple growers and multiple consumers. So if we can match them better, there are probabilities of reducing the wastage, high wastage which we have in this perishable segment.
Yes, that itself is a challenge within its own sector. Perishability must be a huge challenge. But yes, I do believe that women are a natural when it comes to agriculture. Women like you who have, you know, seen the world, are, you know, most educated, professional, and who have chosen this path. So women is a natural at agriculture, at growing, at nurturing, at nourishing. I think it's an easy task, though not very, very easy, but it should come naturally to us women. And hope we get much more encouragement, so you can be actually a role model for all women who would like to enter agriculture and, you know, do a startup and want to do a business out of it. So I think when I speak to women entrepreneurs within womankind also, I do say certain things to them. And one of the most important things that I do say to them is, we will have to keep our gender at home, you know, when we want to become entrepreneurs. So that cannot be a hindrance, that cannot be an impediment. And also that we have a long way to go in terms of how much, to become formidable players in the market, to be taken seriously, to be a player of reckoning. We will have to, come there on an even footing, on a level playing field. Mm-hmm. We cannot ask for a leeway or a concession or some kind of acceptance ki, because I'm a women entrepreneur, thoda sa, please ignore this or please don't look at this problem. So I think we will have to do this very consciously. And I think the world is a giving place, it's a generous place. Mm-hmm. Market is also generous. The market doesn't know your gender. So if we want to enter the market and be a player in the market, we will have to become, really tough. And we have to be a little tough on ourselves. I think that may help, establish us as good entrepreneurs. So let's establish ourselves not as women entrepreneurs, but as good entrepreneurs.
Absolutely. In the beginning. Absolutely.
So this is one thing. And what would your message be to women entrepreneurs of the Women's Day, International Women's Day is coming up very fast, very close by, just around the corner. What would you like to say to women entrepreneurs as a leader in, agri startup? What would you like to say?
See, what I think is hard work and consistency is what is required. So be persistent in whatever you are doing. These challenges are not, only for you. It's mm-hmm. for everybody out there. Mm-hmm. So everybody out there who's struggling to be an entrepreneur and make a business and scale the business is facing these issues and problems. So just don't mm-hmm. be scared of them. Don't think this is a new challenge for you. And just take them in the right stride and just keep persistently pushing for what you are aiming or aspiring at. And obviously, there is no small or big dream. A dream is a dream. So,
wow. Whatever is your dream. Wonderful. That's wonderful. So there's so much to talk and we can go on and continue talking. So many of our experiences, personal experiences. So what has been the most positive takeaway till date from your journey as a entrepreneur and as a woman in agriculture? What is the most positive thing you feel?
The best days are when you get customer testimonials and when the customer mm-hmm. tells you, wow, your basil was the freshest, jo smell aa raha tha wo maine kabhi kisi basil mein nahi dekha. And obviously validation points like बार बार जब वो लोग रिपीट ऑर्डर करते हैं, जो हमारे साथ एक बार आ जाता है कंज्यूमर वो छोड़ता नहीं है. So those are small validations which make you happy.
It interesting, yeah.
And also obviously yes, winning awards, getting validations just gives you a lot of confidence and boosts you and make you stand again yes. for the next day.
Right. It must be like an indicator, okay, you are on the right path, so something right is happening. Mm-hmm. Okay, so if are there any business opportunities? So wherever I go, I do this. Are there any business opportunities for members of womankind? Is there any way in which they can join you for, in a commercial way, in a professional way? We would like to know.
So I'm a member of womankind. And thanks to womankind, it has helped in reaching out to a larger community, and it has made the task easy. So synergies I see, there are several synergies which can be explored. As I told you, I am not there to compete with anybody. I just want as many people to collaborate as possible. So whether it's from supply chain perspective, whether it's from, you know, if they are making something which is boutique and hygienic and following standards, we can look at being a platform to sell it to the larger consumer base across
Right. So I think I missed out on something, Shefalika, and I'm so sorry. I wanted to ask you about sustainability principles. I mean, are you using them? I mean, what is it? Can you tell us very briefly about that?
So sustainability to me is something which can be repeatedly done without any external force or pressure. When we say using sustainable, so while growing also, we are using sustainable techniques, which are, even if we are adopting modern farming techniques, we are making them very, very cost optimal. So, and in localized context, relevant in local context, in Indian context, not as adopted from US or Canada or Australia.
True.
So they themselves become sustainable there. And we are trying to utilize whatever unconventional and unutilized space is available in urban and peri-urban areas. I love this concept of saying, concentricity in supply chain. जो मुझे अर्बन पेरी अर्बन एरियाज में जो मैं ग्रो कर सकती हूँ या अपने घरों में ग्रो कर सकती हूँ या पार्किंग लॉट्स में ग्रो कर सकती हूँ या एज अ
टेरेस पे
या आई शुड ग्रो एंड बाकी नीड्स के लिए वी शुड जस्ट कीप गोइंग टू द पेरिफेरी सो कीपिंग इट एज लोकल एज पॉसिबल
राइट So this idea is again very close to the concept, you know, there are so many principles of a smart city or new urbanism. I think it kind of, shares the boundaries with these principles. Yes. And we should have another chat just to discuss this.
Long topic.
Right. So it was wonderful. Is there anything else you'd like to say? But I'd like to wind up at this point now. Is there anything else you'd like to say?
No, I would like you to end with that quote. quote which you were telling me, because
yes,
that was very inspiring.
So today is Marathi Din or Marathi Bhasha Din. And I love languages, all languages, English, Hindi, Marathi. And Marathi is my mother tongue. Today is Marathi Bhasha Din. So we had a poet saint, Sauta Mali. And Mali means gardener. His name was Sauta. He was a Mali, which is a gardener. And for him, being in the garden and agriculture was a spiritual quest, because he was the closest to nature and closest to God. That was what he felt. So I'm going to give a very cute little abhanga. I'm going to just quote that. I read it out for you, and we will end the session with that. Kanda mula bhaji, avghi vithai majhi. कांदा मुळा भाजी अवघी विठाई माझी लसूण मिरची कोथिंबिरी अवघा झाला माझा हरी ऊस गाजर रताळू अवघा झाला से गोपाळू मोट नाडा विहीर दोरी विहीर इज अ वेल सो मोट नाडा विहीर दोरी अवघी व्यापिली पंढरी फॉर हिम द destination where Vithoba, his loving beloved deity Pandharpur, is where there is water. So he says mota nada vihira dori avghi vyapili pandhari savata mhane kela mala. Mala is garden. Savata mhane kela mala vithala pai govila gala. So this is what he writes about growing vegetables and his spiritual quest or nirvana that he found and the God that he found when he was in his garden. So let's end with this. It was a fantastic session. love to do this. I feel very honored and happy and overwhelmed, you know, that we are doing this together and on such a prestigious platform. Thank you, AICRMP. Thank you, Uday. Thank you, Pallavi. Thank you for this opportunity. And thank you, Shefal.
Thank you.
Thank you, Renuji, for this beautiful abhanga and concluding this baatchit on this very beautiful note. Malika, for this very engaging baatchit. I think the way you pointed out that being woman entrepreneur is a little extra tough. But then when Renuji said that market doesn't know the gender person who's driving the business. So this conversation really brought out how you are coping with this given challenges and the context. It was really a pleasure listening to your rich experiences, and I'm sure that this talk will inspire many more women to take up entrepreneurship and venture into modern sustainable agriculture field. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
For those who are watching this Baatchit live on Facebook, thank you for joining us this evening, and stay tuned to know more about AICRMP's various other activities and next episodes of Baatchit.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye.